See, the secret is that if they're gonna lock you out of any type of industry, they're gonna always use sports to do it. See, sports is just like gambling. Stocks is just like betting and gambling. See, they talked about, like, back in the day, they said back in the 20s and 30s, they talked about how Malcolm X, he used to run numbers. And I don't know if, I think this was like, no, like in the 30s or 40s or something like that. But they basically talked about like how he used to run numbers, and other people like on the streets ran numbers to like get money. But what they don't realize is that the lottery and all of that was getting funded originally by sports, particularly, especially in this area, particularly hockey. So like what happened with me was that, because people wonder like, well, how you know, like you saying like, you know, that they owe you all this money and stuff like that, and I get that, but you know, like, why aren't, you know, the views and stuff like that higher? And I did another video talking about that, but that's not really what I'm going into. But you know, you have people thinking that, and what they don't realize is that the numbers tie into more than just the views, because it's all about the region and the area that you do like a lot of these videos and stuff like that at, right? So like what happened with me was that I was, to them, they was betting on me, and I was like running numbers for them dealing with hockey like a couple years before the coronavirus even came out or whatever. I was doing this kind of like in secret, and I started generating a lot of credit from it, and that's how I ended up eventually cleaning up the debt for my channel, the other channel that I have, which is 13 Signs Astrology. That's how I ended up cleaning up a lot of that debt, and then using that as a tool to kind of like start loaning to cities and stuff like that. And then eventually a lot of these cities ended up falling into different notes and debts and different liens based upon this chain, because I found out that the blockchain that I was running on my channel was going all the way back to the 20s, right? And it was tied into hockey, it was tied into the NHL, and it still is, because the NHL and hockey, see, the Moors essentially pretty much funded that. It's a long story, but if you look at like the original teams in hockey, most of them are in the original places where the temples started at, the original temples of the Moor Science Temple. So like, for instance, like Chicago, they came out in 1924, you know, and the Moor Science Temple of America was founded as a religious corporation in 1913. Well, actually in New Jersey in 1913, I believe like around 1923, 24, it came to Chicago. So like what people don't realize is that it's a secret cabal, especially in NHL with sports, a secret cabal, right, that goes back into nationality and a lot of the stuff that I'm talking about and how the economy used to be ran. So like a lot of the stuff that I'm talking about right now, they look at me as an outlaw, because they like, well, you're talking about doing stuff kind of like as a rogue. But you don't realize that this is how the shit was ran through sports. And this is how really this country was set up, as like a hustle kind of like. And it eventually came and became the corporation looking all pretty and shit like that, that you see now. But originally, it was like a hustle, like. And hockey money is key, and they still owe a lot of money. It's key in why they even brought the coronavirus out, even. Because it started affecting the sports, because a lot of these contracts, these basketball players and stuff like that got, come to find out, ties into hockey money. And hockey money goes back into like sexual occult rituals. Esoteric sexual occult rituals. So it's important that you fully, you know what I'm saying, but before you start talking about sovereignty and really getting into the sovereign aspect of government, you gotta understand like this stuff that I'm talking, like hockey money and going back into like the zip codes and how did the zip codes even get established. This is all going back into hockey money. And like, you know, like you got like, even where I'm at now, like they say like, well, a lot of these people, they want to use their homes and stuff like that as a way to hide. And they say, I don't have to pay money because I could just sit in my home. You don't realize that the home, the hood, got a lot of its money from hockey. And all the homes go back to St. Louis. So the Blues, which is the St. Louis hockey team, stores a lot of your equity and a lot of your money is going back to hockey. So like a lot of the shit that's going on in sports, and why a lot of the money is old, is tied into the fact that they haven't paid off old contracts that can still be proven through mastering zip codes in relationship to learning about sports. And also, there's some secrets involved, though, because this is going to take you into understanding the drugs and the dope aspect of commodities and how shit runs. So I had to come to this little hidden area to do this, man, because you know, where I'm at is kind of like the Serpent Mounds or whatever, so they doing like an outlock, so I had to, you know, come to this area or whatever. You know, you have some rogues following me out here or whatever, so, but it's all good just to drop this information, just to keep it going. But yeah, that's what's going on, man. I want to take you more into the eye, and that's what I'm striving to take you into, but I have to go to certain areas and keep dropping videos on different topics. And I'm trying to show you this is a $1 billion fucking eye. And it's a problem why our currency is so much in debt, and why, you know, there's so much debt that's being played off as credit right now. It's tied into this eye and this land and these contracts that they still owe, tied into Social Security, sports, going all the way back even into military, Morse code even, taking us back into the internet, and even back into, like I said, extraterrestrials. And the story of the Son of Man also, I want to point that out, the story of the Son of Man. In the Bible, they talk about the Son of Man. That's going into hockey. That's what they're talking about, a secret experiment that took place where these males, they said the Son of Man went into the daughters of women. And you think this is some stuff back at Adam and Eve. The Son of Man went into the daughters of men. Or the sons of God, excuse me, went into the daughters of men and had children with them. This is talking about a secret experiment. See, hockey came from Canada, right? But this goes back even into London and Europe and take you back into the Moorish Empire, even into like the Isles of Man and stuff like that. And all this could be charted. All this could be charted. And this is where all the secret technology and all this stuff that I'm talking about with the ET, so you got to follow it through. It starts with the money. And once you start following the money, you get into the land. Then you start following the land and you eventually get into sports. The sports is going to take you out of this country, and then that's when you're going to become international. See how these extraterrestrials really did have an international market. There's nothing new up under the sun. And they're still can be calculated and accounted for to this day. So I'm going to go ahead and shut down. Got to get Showford out of here. Thank you for listening and watching. And as always, stay vigilant.